Hi, this is Brian Kim, and I'm going to share how to make a self-sealing cataract incision every time. Since I've been doing more teaching, I realized that a leaky incision is not an uncommon problem for some surgeons. And so this will be a step-by-step approach on how to ensure a self-sealing incision on a consistent basis. First, we'll show a case from beginning to end, and then we'll show a second case, breaking it down step-by-step, and then we'll show multiple cases just to reinforce the principles. I am a firm believer in maximal efficiency and not doing any wasted movements. And so using a cotton tip to help center the eye from my corneal mark, I use a same cotton tip to pull the eye to the side. And this helps rotate the eye to the left to allow me to create my paracentesis. I use the same cotton tip to pull the eye towards the right to make my left side paracentesis. You want to make a rectangular flat incision. So after placing dispersive viscoelastic into the anterior chamber, I use this same cannula to help control the eye, being able to roll it up or down. I make my vertical groove, use a cannula, pull the eye away from me, place my blade into the groove of the incision. I tunnel and then dive down and create my triplanar corneal incision. After the case is completed, you want to hydrate the sides. And then you're going to find an edge where there's stromal hydration, and you're going to now hydrate the roof. You're going to sweep side to side, and you're going to be able to catch one area that begins to hydrate the cornea. You hydrate the side and then hydrate the roof of the paracentesis. And this is the end of the case. Now we'll go over another case, and we're going to go over each step by step. Again, I use a cotton tip to manipulate the eye to provide access so that I can make a nice rectangular paracentesis incision. Sometimes the eye is not cooperative, so you have to use the cotton tip to move the eye over so you can make a flat incision that's parallel to the iris plane. Rule number one, make a rectangular shaped paracentesis incision with a tunnel longer than the width of the blade. So how do you do this? You want to make the paracentesis incision near parallel to the iris plane. If necessary, use a second instrument such as a cotton tip to turn the eye in order to facilitate a flat approach for the blade to create a longer corneal tunnel. After filling the anterior chamber with viscoelastic, you're going to turn the eye using the cannula and then place the blade in a vertical position. You make your groove and then place the blade within the groove and then tunnel through the cornea to the desired length. And then you're going to go heel up and then stab into the eye to create your corneal incision. So number four, to make a triplanar main incision, you want to make a vertical groove by placing the keratome blade tip within the innermost part of the groove. You flatten the blade out to be near parallel to the cornea and advance the blade. When you've created the desired vertical incision length, tilt the heel of the blade up and advance the blade to penetrate the anterior chamber. Number eight, use a cannula to help rotate the eye for an optimal approach when making these incisions. I prefer hydrating the sides, and then once hydrating the sides, try to catch an area of stromal hydration and start hydrating the roof, sweeping side to side. This creates little areas of hydration. So again, number nine, hydrate the sides of the main incision. Number 10, in order to hydrate the roof, place a cannula within the hydrated corneal stroma in the corner of the incision and gently hydrate while sweeping side to side. When hydrating the paracentesis, I hydrate one side and then hydrate the roof of the incision. So number 11, hydrate the side, then hydrate the roof in similar fashion when hydrating the paracentesis. So now that the case is completed, I'm using a cotton tip to just check the dryness of the incisions. And so we're going to go over multiple cases over and over again. After I make my corneal mark, I use a cotton tip to pull the eye to the left. It flattens out so I can approach the cornea in a more flat manner. Use a cotton tip to pull the eye to the right, and the left paracentesis, again, is flatter. I'm able to make a rectangular paracentesis. Again, the tunnel is longer than the width of the blade. I'm using viscoelastic to fill the anterior chamber. With that same cannula, I'm going to help control the eye. I'm going to make a vertical groove through the limbus, and then place the tip of the blade into the deep part of the incision, a tunnel through the cornea, and then dive down to complete the incision. The reason some people have leaky main wounds is because they don't make a grooved incision, and that means the outermost portion of the incision and wound is just epithelium with a sliver of stroma, and there's no structural integrity to this part of the wound. And so by making a vertical groove, you create much more stromal thickness, much more stromal, stronger integrity, and this allows a stronger incision. So again, I'm hydrating the sides of the incision and then the roof of the incision, sweeping side to side, and then perform a similar technique for the paracentesis. So here's another case. Use the cotton dip to pull the eye to the left. It flattens out the eye for a more flat approach, making the incision of the paracentesis parallel to the iris plane. Fill the eye with viscoelastic and then make my vertical groove. Place the tip of the blade into the deepest part of the groove. Tunnel through the cornea to the desired length and then enter the eye. I'm going to hydrate my incisions, again, hydrating the sides, the right and then the left. Sometimes hydrating the roof is a little bit tricky. You want to kind of angle the cannula tip a little bit more upward and into the actual meat of the stroma of the roof. And then gently you want to hydrate side to side. You never want to be too vigorous because you can actually separate decimates. And so it's very important to be very cautious. Don't use a little bit of pressure, but not such vigorous pressure that you're going to cause a problem. Here's another case using the cotton tip, pull the eye to the left. This allows you to approach the blade parallel to the iris plane so you can get a nice rectangular incision. You do the same thing with the cotton tip, pull the eye to the right, and with the left paracentesis blade, create a nice planar level incision, again, level to the iris plane. Fill the eye with viscoelastic, make your vertical groove, place the tip of the blade through the deepest part of the incision, and then you're going to tunnel, get to the desired length, and then enter into the anterior chamber. You want to, again, hydrate the incisions. You're going to hydrate to the left and then to the right, and then you're going to tilt the cannula up a little bit, make sure you get into the stroma, and you're going to sweep into the roof of the main incision. You see the hydration of the cornea there, and then perform hydration of the side, and then hydration of the roof of the paracentesis. So here's another case. After marking the cornea, use a cotton tip to pull the eye to the left. You make your paracentesis incision flat and parallel to the iris plane, so it creates a nice rectangular incision. You perform the same procedure on the other side, again with the aid of a cotton tip, to make sure you get a nice flat approach. Place it out with viscoelastic with a cannula. Make a vertical groove. Tunnel through the deepest part of the groove and then enter into the eye to make your corneal incision. And go ahead and then hydrate the left and right parts of the incision. And then you're going to go ahead and hydrate the roof. When you hydrate the roof, you sweep side to side very gently, applying some pressure so that you see stromal hydration and whitening, but not such pressure that you cause potential decimated detachment. Go ahead and hydrate the paracentesis side and then the roof as well here. And here's that another case. Mark the central cornea. Use a cotton tip to pull the eye to the left. Flatten out your hand so that you can approach the incision for the paracentesis flat to the iris. Make a nice rectangular incision. Do the same thing on the left side. Using the cotton tip, pull the eye to the right. Make a flat approach with the paracentesis blade flat to the iris so you can make a nice rectangular incision. Use a cannula to fill the eye with viscoelastic. Make a vertical groove through the limbus and then tunnel through the deepest part of the groove and then go into the eye to create your triplanar main incision. After you're done, hydrate the sides of the wound with BSS and then you're going to turn the cannula upward and sweep side to side to hydrate the roof of the incision, and then you're going to hydrate the side of the paracentesis as well as the roof of the paracentesis. You want to make sure your cannula pressure is firm and steady and not too vigorous that you might cause a complication. And here's yet another case. We're going to mark the central cornea. Use a cotton tip to help move the eye to the left. You can have a flat approach and make your paracentesis to get a nice rectangular incision. Use a cotton tip to pull the eye to the right. You're going to have a flat approach, again, staying near parallel to the iris plane. You want to stay as flat as possible to get that nice rectangular incision. And then you're going to fill the eye with viscoelastic, make a vertical groove. And then with the blade tip going into the deepest part of the groove, you're going to tunnel through the corneal stroma and then dive into the eye to create your nice rectangular incision. You're going to go ahead at the end of the case to hydrate the right and left sides of the main incision, turn the cannula upward, and then gently sweep side to side to get nice stromal hydration of the roof of the cornea. Again, being careful not to hydrate too much or cause a decimate separation. You're going to hydrate the side and then the roof of the paracentesis here to, again, have your self-sealing incisions. So these are the last two cases. Again, the main principles are to use a cotton tip to help rotate the eye so that you can make the exact most precise angle when you're making your paracentesis. You want to be as flat as possible to the iris plane so you get a nice rectangular incision. Again, sometimes what happens is you're not intentional. You make your incision and it's a very short incision, and then you're destined to have a leaky wound. And so you want to make it as long as possible. The longer, the better. In fact, I don't really care how long it is. As long as the length of the incision is longer than the width of your blade, then you should be good to go. But the longer it is, it's going to be fine. In fact, it'll be even more likely to seal at the end of the case. And similarly, when you make your main incision, you want to make that nice vertical groove that provides enough structural strength to the external most portion of the wound of the incision. Remember, without that groove, you actually just have a little sliver, a wedge of epithelium, and a thin layer of stroma. This provides no structural integrity. In fact, it just kind of flops around and dangles when you try to lift it. If you make that groove, it's actually pretty strong and rigid, not dissimilar to a femtosecond LASIK flap that has a nice, again, vertical aspect to the edges of the flap. This provides extra strength. And so when you're able to hydrate the roof of the incision, again, that just fortifies the strength of that main wound. I'm confident that if you follow the principles on this video, this should help drastically reduce the occurrences of a wound leak and your need to stitch the wound closed. I hope this was helpful to you, and thank you for your attention.